Hey guys, Carlos here with J. Carlos FitLab, creator of the FitLab method. And today, what I thought I would do is share with you guys the main problem that a lot of runners that I'm working with are dealing with, which is IT band, chin splints, and a lot of back pain. But today I want to focus on IT band and chin splint. First of all, I want to take you guys really quick in this short video of how to go by yourself through the process. So the first thing I tell my clients and anybody that I try to help is to do a gait analysis. So if you go to a good running store before you buy the shoe, they will actually look at your gait and see how you're running. Now, if you do not have access or you already bought the shoes and you're still dealing with the IT band and chin splint, there are a couple of self-tests that I want to show you guys that you should do and then proceed. Okay, so the first thing is figure out what kind of a runner, what type of a running style are you using for your training. There's three different tests that we do for that. The first one is the pedicure bounce. The next one is the toe bounce. And then last is the spring bounce. And these are all based on when you're running, where you're striking that first touch on the ground, because everything changes, right? When the heel strikes the ground, everything changes. And just on a sidebar, kind of like a trivia, 55% of runners are heel striker, meaning when they first run and hit the floor, they strike the ground with the heel. 30% are toe runners, and those are your typical sprinter, and they're the ones that actually run like really on their toes. And only 15%, believe it or not, are the ones that are more on the ball, the foot, midfoot area. And believe it or not, those are the ones that are better off style as far as less injuries and less aches and pain. So let's go through the self-test really quick. Pedicure bounce. With the pedicure bounce, the reason I call it a pedicure bounce is because if you ever have pedicures done, this is how you walk after you're done with your pedicure. So you want to be able to do is bounce in place 4 or 5 times with your toes off the ground. Okay, if you're able to do that comfortably, then you're a pedicure type of runner, so you are a heel striker runner. Then the next one is your toe bounce, and that's the people that are able to be faster, more like a sprinter, and you're on your toes and you do about 4 or 6 of those. And as you can see, I'm pretty comfortable with that as more than with the pedicure bounce. Now, the last one is the spring bounce, and that's more of the ball of the foot more than your toes. And I don't know if you guys can tell the difference. I'm on my toes there. This is the ball of the foot. So, again, you do the bounce. See that? So you can tell a difference personally yourself. That's what we call it, a self-test, because you feel less jarring. There's more shock absorption. Okay. So once you figure this part, then you move into the area that you're dealing with, the painful area. Okay, so what I did today, I kind of use a little mark here because a lot of my runners were having trouble with their IT bands and their calf and getting chin splints. So real quick, let's go back to basic. I always go back to the kinesiology and biomechanic. With the IT band is a tendon, so it's really not much you can like really kill it and stretch it and, you know, beat it to the pulp with it. But what you can do is all the muscles that attach to it, the vastus, the quad lateralis here, the hamstring, all the muscles that are surrounding it, you actually can do some soft tissue work. Now, as far as soft tissue work, I got a few of the tools that I have my clients use. We got the trigger point ball. We got the myofascia. This is one of my favorite ones to do. Trigger point quad roller. If you're familiar with trigger point and the grid roller, and of course the good old foam roller from old school days. And then if you have none of these, because for some reason you're just getting into running, a good old rolling pin will do just fine. So that's a quick run on the different tools you have available to work the muscles around it. So again, you're not going to be on the IT band, you're going to be working the muscles around it. So with the quad bowler, this is the name of it, you'll be putting it on your quad. Okay. And what I see a lot of people do at the gym is that they roll back and forth. And that's just massaging it. You want to release the muscle, the tension in the muscle. So in order to do that, you take the muscle through the movement for the quads. You just kick your legs like that. And I do like 4, 6, and then relocate it to a higher spot on the quad. Okay, and it's a big group, so you kind of chunk it up a little bit, and then you can actually roll it and make it feel a little bit better. Okay, and you can do that with each of these tools here. Okay, same thing is going to happen when you get to the hamstring. Okay, so you place the device that you're going to be using on that muscle, and with the hamstring, it's a extender, so you're going to be here, and then you're going to go with the knee straight and then bend it. Bend and straight, so you take it through the motion and then you can massage it. Okay, a lot of people just spend time here and they say, oh yeah, I've been rolling, but you're just massaging it, right? You're not releasing the tension in the muscle that is actually aggravating and irritating the tendon, because the IT band, again, it attaches all the way. I didn't drew it all the way up to my groin, hip, pelvis area, but it goes all the way to the TFL, which is right next to the hip flexor. And yes, a lot of people focus on the hip flexors, but we got to go with biomechanically and kinesiology what's right for you. Okay, so that's with the IT band. Shin splint, same basis, is fascia in the middle. You got muscles, the anterior tip coming from the front, the soleus coming on this side, the medial calf muscle coming around here. So you really want to address the muscles around the area so you actually lower the irritation to the region. Okay, now I had a few clients earlier asking, how do I know if it's shin splint versus a stress fracture? And there's a couple things that if you want to kind of check yourself before you go into the doctor, you can do. One of them is keep track if your pain is mostly in the morning. If it's mostly in the morning, it's very likely it's a stress fracture. Stress fracture also are known to be very localized. So you're sore right there, you're sore right there, versus the shin splints, kind of like the peripheral, we call it. So they kind of dissipate around up and down. Sometimes they go on the outside here. So that's another thing. Third and not least, when you are doing this, the ringing of the ankle this way, okay, you're most likely feel the shin splint or up and down the shins here. Or if you use the other foot on top of it like this, and you push this way against it, you feel the shin splint's kind of getting irritated versus very localized. So those are your three quick self-test you can do before you go in to see a doctor and get it finalized, x-rayed and all that jazz, okay? Last but not least, going back to the board here, the one thing I want to reiterate, all my runners that I work with and come to me reaching out for help to get them back on the road, these are your four big pillars during season that you really have to take care of. Your psoas, your hip flexors, your quads, which are part of your hip flexor, but you want to really take one time and spend time on the quads, your hamstrings back here, and your calf. Your calves are your money. Those are your fuel right there, okay? So I hope this short video was helpful. Definitely let me know what you think about it. And next time, for those of you guys that are interested on how to use kinesio tape to alleviate IT band and shin splint in between self-treatment or therapy sessions, just let me know, because we're going to be going over how to use this for good and not evil. All right, talk to you guys later, and I hope to hear back from you.